All right, so I'm going to talk now about the power of the Republican Party and how they've become so great all through these years. You know, we've had this wonderful, like, little cutesy outbreak of flower power in the 1960s, and all along there was this big grabbing at them, this big mean machine of industry just grabbing at them, saying no. I'm like, well, how did they take hold so strong all along, even this last election? So I'm looking at right now where they've hid themselves as being great. They've hidden industry in the Republican Party. They've tucked it away, and they have hidden it behind religion. They have hidden it behind God. They have hidden it behind ethical. They have hidden it behind morality. So industry is not even thought about. They have just blasted with advertisement. They have blasted the populations of the world that the Democratic Party, any liberal party, is unethical, is immoral, are drug addicts, and don't practice going to church and do not believe in God. That has been their big seller. And wow, it has won for a lot of years. And it won this last election. I don't really think it has anything to do with anything to do in the Middle East. I don't think it has to do with war machines. I really think it goes right back to the heart of the factor. 1960s, there were a whole bunch of saying, I don't believe in going to church anymore. I don't want to go to your God pew. And it was the break of those children and those parents. And it has continued. And it has continued. And they run back and say, well, you know, we're the better people. You know, they run back to that on their church pew. We're the better people. Yeah, and there goes another pedophiler priest to your better people. Okay. So yeah, we know the Republican Party and its dedication hold in people's mind is God. They use God on their sway side. And so therefore they're like, well, we can't be evil. We believe in God. And the Democratic Party, the most of you for the most part, don't. So this is where they have kept their strength, their control strength. It's because some of you just cannot part with God. You have to keep God as your wake-up call every day. And so thusly, you force yourself to be a Republican. You force yourself to eat industry crap because of this God factor. So anyway, that's it. That's why they've kept their control. It's just God. You know, and by running around and pointing fingers and saying, you're unethical, you're unethical, you're unethical, you're unethical. You're immoral. If anybody Democrat, immoral. And yeah, okay, so like little Hillary, she goes out there and she tries, doesn't she? She's tried. She tried to, like, yeah, well, there's the God thing, and she'll say it a little bit. But deep down in the undertone, it's always heavier on the Republican side as they're advertising in those little stupid communities all across the South. God is your keeper. God is your witness. Be unto him and no other first. As they are advertising that, as the jerks are going to their Kentucky Fried Chickens and their McDonald's, as they are advertising that, as they're running to their instant crap food that they refuse to even change to get the salads when they started serving salads, They're getting their instant commercial there, right on the city streets. They get it right here, even in Pacifica. There's some church that is allowed to advertise and just say, put a big R, just put a massive damn R on that highway. Say, Republicans, are we? That's what he is allowed to do. That's what that church has been allowed to do. Now you can go and say, well, Clinton was a Baptist. Well, that was the only thing that got him into public office. That was the only thing. Had he not run so thick with that agenda, he would never have become president. That is a sick and disgusting thing right now. As we're looking at, the only way to win a presidency is to pour that sick syrup of God over everyone. So, anyway, let's ban. I want those banned. I don't ever want to see a Baptist, a Methodist. I don't want to see any Bible thumping rhetoric on a sign that is next to any public highway, that is next to any public road, because this is apparently supposed to be America, United States of. That freedom of their over-practice has brought us into the situation where we have ended up with Clinton, who Clinton really was not, I'm not going to say jump out of the box, a green man. You know what I'm saying? He just wasn't. He did not pull up the ante. Okay, so take down those signs. All of you church people, take down those signs. They do not create better people. They have only proven to destroy our planet. That has been the sell. That has been their deep sell. Anyway, I think you understand what I'm saying. I think you understand.